Hello everyone, myself Mohammad Ramiz and I welcome you all on behalf of Saraswat International Academy. Today in this session, we are going to learn the part 2 of chapter number 1, that is Nature and Significance of Management. So students, in the previous session, we have studied about what is management and we have also seen the characteristics and you can also say the features of management. We have seen that management is a universal process. Management is used at every places where there is a group of people working with a similar objective. Management is used at a social and religious fields also, in the agriculture, in the army, in the education, all at these places the management is used. We have also seen the second feature, that is goal-oriented activity. Management is a what? It is a tool and not the attainment. Every business unit established to achieve certain objective. And for achieving this objective, what helps us? Management help us. Then we have also seen about that management is a group activity. Management is a which? Collective activity. And it is carried by two or more person. Management is required where two or more people are working together for the accomplishment of the predetermined goal. So these three characteristics we have discussed in the previous session. Now we are going to see the other characteristics of management. The fourth characteristic, that is continuous process. Management is a continuous process. When once the business is started, the management is continuously going on. Once the management begins, it become difficult to discontinue it. Till the time you are running the firm, you are running the business, you require what? You require the management for the completion of goal. Okay, management is what? Goal oriented. Yet it does not stop after the achievement of the objective. Once you decide your objective and your short term goals are achieving, okay, then it doesn't mean that you will stop your management. You will have the long term objectives also. So you will continue. You will continue what you are. You will continue the process of your management. Management cannot stop. New objectives. Okay. Once your smaller objective or short-term objective are achieved, then what? Then new objective and targets will be decided by the business unit. And for achieving this new objective, you will use management. The cycle of defining objective, then achieving them and redefining them continuously going on. So here it is said that management is a continuous process. Once a goal, short term goal is achieved, then other objective is decided. If that is achieved, then other than that, the new objective will decide it. Okay, so management will be going on till your business is there. So here it is proved that management is a which process? Continuous process. Now the fifth characteristic, that is a human process. Management process is limited to human activities in spite of its universality. This is we have discussed in the first point, that management is a concept which is used everywhere, in the social process, in the religious, in the army, in the sports. Management is used. Now here in this line the focus is about that management process is limited to human activities. Okay, in a business the person who manages is called as a manager. The manager is a what? The manager is a human being, and to whom he is managing, they are also the human being. So that's why it is said that management is a which process? Human process. Human element is significant element in the management. Human element is the what? Is the most important element in the management. Other means of production are useless without men. See, if you are starting a business, you start a manufacturing industry, you have the machines and you have the raw material, you have the resources, but you don't have a human, resourceful human. The workers are not efficient, the manager are not efficient, then you cannot achieve your goal. Okay, so what is the basic thing? That the resourceful human being should be there in your firm. The managers should be good. Okay, then only you can achieve your goal. So management is done by the human being. The manager is managing, and to whom he is to whom he is managing, that all that persons are also human being. Okay, so again, management is done by the human being and for the human being. Man is in the center of management. Thus, it is a human process which is done by the man and for the man. Okay, it is done by the manager and for the what? For the employees of the firm. Sixth characteristics, that is decision process. Decision process is the function of management. Okay, management in the starting, we have seen that management have the different functions: planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, reporting, budgeting. These all are the functions of management. In the same way, the taking of the decision taking, it is also what? It is also one of the function of management. Management has to take decision constantly. Okay, the person who are managing the business, the different departmental managers, they have to continuously what? They have to continuously take the different decisions while managing the business. No work can be done without taking the decision. Obviously, without taking any of the decision, nothing can be done in a business. You have to take every day the different decisions for the betterment of the management, for the betterment of the firm. After taking decision, after you take the decision, management has to proceed to implement it. One is to decide, another is to implement it. Okay, you are deciding that you want to achieve 80%, and for that you have to work. That is the other thing. Okay, so same way, management have to what? Management have to take the decisions, and for management is only responsible that decision should be implemented in the firm. Thus, decision process is the what? Is a function of management. Like planning, organizing, staffing are the functions of management. In the same way, decision process is also the function of management. The seventh characteristic, that is management, is science, art and profession. Like science, management has its own rules or principles. So till the 10th standard you have learned science, and in that we have seen that there are the different laws, principles in science. We have studied the gravitational force and everything. Okay, so in science runs about the what? About laws and principle. In the same way, in the management also, there are the different management experts such as Henry Fayol, Peter Drucker. These are the experts who have given the principles of management. And the second chapter, principle of management, is all about it. In that, we are going to learn the different laws and principle about how to do the management. See the next thing. Hence, many writers consider management as a science. So as I've told you that in management, there are different rules and principle how to manage the business. That's why many of the writers have told that management is what? Management is a science. Man is an important factor of management. Therefore, getting work done from him require what? Proficiency, intelligence, cleverness and insight. Okay, as a manager, you are going to manage to whom? You are going to manage to the human beings. Okay, man is an important factor of management, and it is very important for you to have some skills to manage the man. You should be good in proficiency, you should have the good intelligence, cleverness and insight. Then only you can manage the man. To manage the machinery is easy. You will switch on the button, switch off the button. But now you are managing to whom? You are managing to human beings. So you should have the different characteristics of intelligence and skill. Then only you can manage the what? Then you can manage the human being. It is known as what? It is known as art. That you are having an art to get the work done from others. Okay, so here it is proved that management is what? Management is an art. Management of a modern business unit is handed over to trained and expert people. Now, if you will see in the business, in the firm, okay, you will see there are the different experts like finance manager, marketing manager, human resource manager. So different train and expert people are there who do the work of management. In recent time, managers have also adopted the professional, like what, lawyers, doctors and chartered accountant. Thus it is clear that management is what? Management is a profession too. So here we have seen that management is what? Management is science, management is art, and management is profession. So till now we have seen the seven characteristics of what? Of the management. This whole answer can come for 3 marks or 5 marks. Students, our new topic is importance of management. In the previous session, we have studied about characteristics of management. So when it is asked in the board examination, please don't get confused. You always have to see what question it is asked. Here it is what? Importance of management. So let's start the topic. Management has great importance in the modern time. In this modern era, if you will see, management is required in every field. Either it is a sports, cultural, religious, or in managing the multinational companies. The management is required. The efficient management, I will say. The efficient management is required. Success or failure of any business activity depend on its management. Success or the failure of any business depend on the management. If the management panel, it means departmental head and the experts of your business firm are good, then you will get what? You will get success. If the management is not good, then you will lead to failure or loss. If management contains limitation, despite the availability of modern and sufficient resources, its maximum utilization is not possible. So here it is said that if the management is inefficient, if the management is not good, then you are having the modern technology, you are having the sufficient resources. But because of the lack of management, because of the what? Lack of management, inefficient management, you will not be able to utilize your resources in a best possible manner. So it is very important for the firm that the management should be good. The layout of machinery is there, but it has its drawback. If efficient human resource is there, but its management is not proper, then the business would fail. So here it is said, the layout of machinery is there, but it has its drawback. If there is an inefficient management, if human, the employees you are having, they are good, but the management is not proper, then you will not be able to use the employees in a best possible manner, and you will lead to what? You will lead to failure. The importance of management is made clear by the following points. Now we will learn the different points of the importance of management. The first point, as you can see, that management is necessary in every field. Management is required not only in business activity, but also in all the type of activities such as religious, defense, society, politics, education and sports. So here it is said that management is not only used in business, but it is also used in the different activities such as religious activity, defense activity, society, politics, education and sports. So this we have seen before also, that management is universal. Management is required in each and every field where more than 2 persons are working together with a common goal. Management functions like what? Planning, organizing, direction and control are required in all these activities. So we know that, we have discussed this, that functions of management are planning, organization, directing, control. Other functions are reporting, budgeting, coordinating. So these are the functions of management, and it will help to what? Success of the management. Optimum utilization of resources. First of all, you have to understand what is resource. In a business, land, capital, the money you invested, the raw materials you are having, the personal means the human employees you are having which are skillful, okay, and machinery. These all are the resources for you in a business, okay. So optimum utilization of resource means using your resources in a best possible manner. Management makes it possible to take the optimum utilization of business resources. Okay, if there is a good management, if there is a what? Good management, then your all the resources will be used in a best possible manner. A good management avoids the wastage of resources. If the management is good, then your resource will not be wasted. If the management is inefficient, then your resources will be wasteful. They will not use the resource in a best possible manner. So it is very important that management should be efficient. Now see the third point. Accomplishment of objective. Accomplishment of objective means achieving your objective. Management is necessary for the accomplishment of objective. If there is a good management, then it will lead to complete your goals of the business. Management make it possible to take the what? To take the optimum utilization of resource, which help to achieve the business objective. Okay, so here it is said that management is necessary for accomplishment of the business goal. If the good management is there, then it is possible to use all your resources in a best possible manner, and it will lead to achieve the business objective. Useful for the success of business. In the success of a business unit, contribution of management is more as compared to the other elements in the success of the business. So here it is said that if there is a success of the business, then its entire credit will go to what? Will go to the management. Compared to the other elements of the business, if there is a good management, it will lead to what? It will lead to success. Success or failure of a business depend on the management. So if there is a success in the business, then it result is because of the good management. If there is a failure, then it will result because of what? Because of inefficient management. So success or failure depend on what? Depend on the management. Good management will lead to success. Inefficient management will lead to failure. If a small scale industry can convert itself into a large scale industry, then its entire credit goes to management. If the small scale industry is now converted into a what? Large scale industry. Then the reason behind that is good management. If the management is good, then the small scale business can convert itself into a large scale business. Efficient management help to convert a loss making unit into a profit making unit. If there is a efficient and good management, then a loss making firm can convert itself into a which firm? Profit making firm. Increase in job opportunities. If management is efficient, the firm soon develop itself in the form of a company, where inefficient management becomes responsible for the closure of many companies, which lead to further increase in unemployment. So here in this point it is said that if the management is good and efficient, then the firm, a small business, can convert itself into a company. And if there is a what? If there is an inefficient management, then it will lead to what? Closure of the business. And as the business will close down, then it will lead to unemployment. Okay. And if there is a good management, then a small firm can convert itself into a company, and there will be increase in employment opportunities. And if there is a bad management, inefficient management, then the business will close. And many people will get what? Many people will get unemployed. Increasing profit. Generally, business unit work with the motive of profit. We know that business starts with the motive of what? With the motive of getting profit. Competent and proficient manager, with their insight and proficiency, make the maximum and the most economical utilization of available resource and earn maximum profit. So here it is said that the good managers, the skillful manager, they use their skill and talent and
use the resources of the business in best possible manner and earn the maximum profit. Therefore, it is rigidly said that the profit is the barometer for the efficiency and success of the business. So here therefore it is said that profit is the barometer for the efficiency and success of the business. If the business is having the good manager, then you will get more profit. If the business in the firm, if there is an inefficient management, then the profit will be less and sometime it will lead to failure also. Social benefit, social welfare. Every business is carried out as a part of society and for the interest of society. So here it is said that every business is running in the society and at the end they do the welfare of the society. So in the 11th standard we have seen that the main objective of the business is what? Is to get the profit. But in the secondary objective we have discussed that the many of the firms are having the goal to do the social welfare also. Because business is a part of the society. If you are running a business, you are getting the employees from the society. You are selling your goods to the consumer. They are also the part of society. So business is considered as a part of society. And in return, many of the business are doing the social welfare. By using resources of the society, management work in the favor of the society. So in this corona pandemic also we have seen many of the multinational companies also and many of the Indian companies have given their contribution in the PM Care Fund. Okay, so that shows that business are giving their contribution for the welfare of the society. So here it proves that by using the resources of the society, management works in the favor of the society. Business are using the resources from the society and in return they are doing the favor for the society by doing the welfare of the society. Success of any business increases the wealth and welfare of society. Business unit produce goods and service at low cost. The success of the business increases the wealth and welfare of society. If the business are running well, then at the end they are going to do the welfare of the society. For example, Tata is one of the company who is giving their contribution of the profit to the welfare of the society. And business unit produce goods and service at low cost. Business will produce their goods at what? At low cost. This provides goods at reasonable rate. And as the cost is low, then they will able to provide, the business will able to provide the goods at reasonable rate to the consumer and it will lead to what? Welfare of the entire society. National motive. Management is essential to take maximum utilization of untapped human resource and factor of production for the economical, social and rational development of an economy, of a country. So here it is said that management is essential, management is necessary to make the utilization of untapped human resource. There are the human who are not used, whose skill are not come out. If there is a good management, then they will utilize this human resource, they will train their employees, they will teach them the skills and the human resource of our country will be used in a good way and factor of production that will be used for the what? For the betterment of economical, social and national development of the country. So here we complete the what? Importance of management. Students, here are the questions from the part 1 and part 2. Listen, you are now in board examination and each and every topic are important for you. Each and every line of textbook are important for you. Here I am just giving you the textual questions and that you have to note down in your notebook. See the first question. Give the benefits of management to the society. Second, what is management? And third is, you have to define here in the second question that what is management? And third question is, which fields are developed through management? These three questions are one-line questions. Now the fourth question, you can say, discuss the importance of management. You have to write down this in detail. These are the detailed question. And fifth question is, define management and explain its characteristics.